Physics, psychology, stats, writing. But keep in mind that all these services are for free and open to all Lakeland students. Students can register for tutoring at My Lakeland, schedule it, or by walking into the Learning Center in A1044.
Interviewing workshop, learn what to say and what not to say and how to say it so they say you're hired. This workshop is on Friday, November 15th, 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. Registration is required. Stop past Career Service, office A1039, or contact them by phone at 440-525-7222.
You make no friends in the pits and you take no prisoners. 1 minute you're up $500,000 in soybeans and the next, boom, your kids don't go to college and they've repossessed your Bentley. Are you with me?
The revolution starts now.
We have to pass the bill so that you can find out what is in it.
Turn those machines back on!
And we have to start by building a wall, a big, beautiful, powerful wall.
Show me the money!
You are fake news.
Oh, good for you. And how was it?
I don't know when they decided that they wanted to make a virtue out of selfishness.
If we lose freedom here, there's no place to escape to. This is the last stand on earth.
Well, that's a revolution here on Lake Effect Radio, streaming live at lakeeffectradio.org/studio and many other different places. Abidor Fallis in the house.
Yeah, Abidor Fallis. This is a new song called Homesick. We're going to play off the new album right now, so we're just gonna hit it. A little bit of murder folk for the Halloween season.
Again, somewhere in Spain, yeah. I kill this man in Idaho, but it don't feel the same when I'm abroad. And I don't know what to do. I got them feeling American Psycho blues. Them girly screaming Russian, little different when in Rome. It don't carry quite the same when I kill them back home. I'm a little down. I got them feeling American Psycho blues. Well, I tell you right now, sonny, talk is pretty cheap. Things get kind of messy when the blade's pushed in too deep. So many you walk so life out there, put you all to end. I know we're seeing eye to eye, hoping you'll meet again. Travel this great world falls from sea to shining sea. Folks wave as they pass by with little concern to me. Days I'm just a wanderer and I'm happy as a clown. Obsession might come over me when I come through your town. Well, I killed a man in Tokyo, yet another in Berlin. Another still in Singapore, next stop is the Vatican. Well, I'm a little down. I don't know what to do. I got them feeling American Psycho blues. I got them feeling American Psycho blues.
Very nice. So I had to ask, what have you been up to since, what, a year?
Yeah, at least a year. We put another album out. I did an album called You Mean a Devil Make Three, which had a couple singles on it that did pretty well. And then just been touring, man, and doing shows and trying to get more and more stuff done. Just got back from Salem, Massachusetts, and just put new stuff out. Got the new album out. This is called Dark Folk, which is going to be pretty cool. First time ever with a permanent second member. Abidor Fallis has never had another member in it, but Brian Haley on bass joined about 4 months ago, maybe?
May.
Yeah. Something like, yeah, something in May. Yes, there you go.
Yeah, pretty close. Four or five, something like that.
And he's been doing shows with me, and yeah, and it's a permanent thing, man. So we got bass, still looping the drums and still looping, you know, but a permanent bass player now. So that changed.
So, you know what that means. Especially for the new guy. That way you start asking him here and there questions.
Yeah, yeah. He's going to have to answer them. He probably might not like it.
He might not like it. That's what happens.
It is what it is, right? It is.
Yeah, something like that. That's what I keep telling myself. Don't worry. I'll be your stand-up comedian today.
It's cool.
Ish.
Ish.
No promises there. So, what attracted you to this project?
He was doing like an open, like fill-in spot at a local spot in Conneaut, Ohio, called Breakwall Barbecue, and kind of just posted an open invite on Facebook. Anyone who plays an instrument, come on down, bring your instrument. And we started jamming together, and even though we'd never played together before, if you didn't know we hadn't played together before, you wouldn't have been able to know sitting out there that day. So we started hooking up and jamming some other stuff, because like I'm really into like funk and R&B music and stuff like that. And he's like, well, what do you think about being full-time in the Abaddon Phallus project? And you know, any opportunity to not only play good music but play music as often as we do is definitely a good time.
I feel it.
Yeah, and the crazy thing was too is like, okay, so this is like an open mic, open jam. It wasn't really an open mic; it was like an open jam setting. So it was supposed to be where someone would come down, play, and then you'd switch off musicians, and other people would play. And me and Brian, the drummer, played the whole night. Like, no one else even played.
3 hours.
Like 3 hours. We're like, it's just us, guys. Never mind. Everybody just go out. Let's go home. We're good. That's pretty much how that went. And then we just did it all summer. So, yeah.
But just took it to all different states.
Yeah, well, with the jam thing we did. And then when Abaddon Phallus, when he joined Abaddon Phallus, now we do, you know, it's Abaddon Phallus. We just tour that, and yeah, man. I mean, we got some really cool stuff in January. We got a tour in North Carolina coming up that we're just finishing wrapping up as far as booking it. And then I got one in February that's more towards like Syracuse, Utica, like
New
upstate
York.
New York.
And
yeah, you know, so we're doing that, trying to get the new album out there and get people listening to that. So yeah.
What other tricks do you have up your sleeve before the end of the year /
Honestly, man, nothing. I pulled back a lot. I kind of got rid of projects I just wasn't really doing too much of. I mean, I still have my metal band, Anthems of Apathy. We still do that. But outside of that, man, I really pulled back a lot. I'm pretty much just primarily focusing on Abaddon Phallus. I'm going to do the same much, very shameless plug I have to do. So saying that, picked up some new endorsements since you last saw me.
Okay.
Yeah, you know, so shout out to EMG Pickups, Coffin Cases, Trident Media Picks, Black Arts Toneworks, GNH Plugs from Meadville, PA, Villains Wear from Pittsburgh, PA, SIT Strings from Akron, Ohio, Killer Bee Guitars from Memphis, Tennessee, and Live Loop from the Netherlands. I'm on endorsed by a looping company out of the Netherlands. They make looping software. If you go to liveloop.live, you can check that out.
No, that makes sense.
Yeah, man, yeah.
That
I mean,
makes
I loop,
sense.
Right? So that is what it is, yeah.
It's a lot of many people, you know, singer-songwriters that, you know, do the whole looping thing.
Mm-hmm. I remember when I started it, no one really cared about doing it much. And then Ed Sheeran did it on a show once. Everybody's like, I got a loop too. And here's the thing, and I'm going to say this. This sounds like I'm being kind of a jerk, but here's my thing. To all you loopers out there, do me a huge favor. If you're going to be a looper, be good at it. Because you make my job hard when you suck at it, and then I have to go and explain to the bar that I'm a looper, but actually show them that looping is good. Because I have a hard time getting gigs, man, because so many people are bad at it. That bars are like, I usually don't tell anybody I'm a looper until I just play a show. Because if I do, they're like, oh, looper, and they get all. So if you're a looper out there, please practice your skill first in your garage, basement, whatever it is. Get really, really good at it, and then come out and do it. Thank you. Service announcement from Abaddon Phallus.
Yeah. Watch a couple Reggie Watts tutorials.
Yes.
Maybe some Mark Rebillet.
Right, yeah. Watch Joe Driscoll from Syracuse. That's my boy right there. You know, if you get good at it, then come out when you can stay in time. And then, yeah, thank you. That's just, please, you're making my job hard.
man, never see that one coming.
Yeah, most people are like, well, that's mean. I'm like, I'm just being serious. You're killing me.
No, I definitely see it because it's becoming a more bigger trend now than in the past and that. Especially sort of the singer song more that way.
Yep.
But then in a way necessarily some bands are actually sort of collaborating that in.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, so I've seen it. Yeah, there's a couple metal bands that are doing it, and I think that's pretty unique and cool. But for the most part, yeah, it's like singer-songwriter guys that don't want to have a band. They want to have an acoustic act, but they want to sound full, so they'll loop, and some of them are just very bad at it, and it makes it hard. I physically have lost gigs because they saw that I was a looper, and they didn't even want to even give it a shot. Because they've literally said to me, we've had so many loopers that were bad, we don't want to even... So now I don't even advertise it anymore. Like, my record label's like, don't even talk about it. Just say... We're a two-piece folk act. Done. Like, yep, that's what we do now. Yeah. We seem to have any troubles now. But
I feel it.
Yeah.
I feel it. I understand.
So now let me ask you a question. So what do you think of the new singles, man? What do you think? We sent you two new singles. I mean, you know, what's your thought on from what Abaddon Phallus was to what it is now? Because it's very different.
Oh, God, yeah. It's 100% different. Mm-hmm. It's almost like that complete split of,
right.
You know, it's... complete opposite.
It is, because it used to be very Leonard Cohen-y. Very, very Leonard Cohen kind of sounding. Now it's more like AJJ or like Harley Poe. It's very shuffly and like very very much more acoustic, not so produced. It's kind of raw. The tracks are kind of raw compared to what they were on History of Judeca.
It's kind of funny that he can best describe it, too, because some of the things, it's like, yeah, that's sort of exactly what I was sort of thinking.
Yeah, so it's different. So, I mean, you dig it? You like it better?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I like the sound myself a little bit better.
It's probably occasionally like the speed off of that.
Yeah, we, all right, so let me just kind of like, so here's what happened. Let me just tell you what happened. So when I started doing this whole project, it was very Leonard Cohen based, right? And then I was fine with that. And then when I met Haley and we started jamming, I was like, man, I got to get more folky. Like, I want to get more, like, almost kind of funny. We'll play a song coming up here that called Straight Jackets and Lemonade. That's just like the songs are starting to get kind of humorous as well as being dark, which we are finding that crowds, funny enough, the older crowds really get a kick out of what I'm doing. And some of the younger crowds get kind of upset. They're like, bro, you're talking about, you know, they get all like, you're talking about murder. It's so horrible. And the old people are like, that is funny. You just talked about that girl in the trunk. That's funny.
Yeah.
I'm like, yeah, it's funny. You know, and it's, you know, we're finding that with it being folky rather than kind of poetic or, you know, more serious. We're kind of making it more jam bandy almost.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? We seem to get
not
it better.
Not with even the older generation sort of that with, you know, the old style, even like circus stuff and that, you know, sign someone in half and that they've been more experienced towards that compared to like you go to someone that's 17-year-old and say, hey, you know, name me something weird that you've seen at a circus or, you know, heard of.
They don't even know. Not a musical, they don't even
know. It
would
be like,
yeah, they saw an elephant.
Yeah, that's it.
Right, you know, and it's like I always kind of sell it like this. I sell Abaddon Phallus now as I want you to imagine if James Taylor or Jim Croce decided to murder people and sing about it. There you go. That's what it is. That's what Abaddon Phallus technically is, with a little bit of country. Shooter Jennings. If Shooter Jennings shot people, Shooter, I know you've shot people. Don't lie. My dad's Waylon.
Maybe Waylon did.
Waylon definitely killed people.
Yeah.
And he's the man, so I'm not going to diss any of that. I love Shooter. If you're out there listening to Shooter, which I don't think you are, but if you are, I love you. He's touring with Duff McKagan right now.
He might listen. I mean, he got kicked out of Nashville.
He did. He's touring with Duff McKagan right now, which is pretty awesome.
Damn.
So, yeah, right, dude? Because Duff McKagan went and did country music, but Shooter's like, let me produce that for you. It's
wanted
amazing.
Wanted to make some money.
Yeah. Shooter. Duff. Murder.
Duff beer.
Duff beer.
That's what I was.
Right. Yeah. Right.
Oh, man.
So you want us to jam another song?
Yeah.
All right. We'll do another one. All right. So this song we're talking about, Straight Jackets and Lemonade, this is a stalker song. This is like about a guy who sees a girl and he's just like, I love you on first sight. And then he stalks her up until his demise. And his demise is pretty funny. So...
I met you in St. Louis at that local county fair. You were walking with a couple friends, and I was close enough to smell your hair. I lost sight of you for a little while, eating, walking, enjoying rides at a stand with hoops and gadgets. I found you in the corner of my eye. I know this was meant to be. When you looked over at me, I froze and softly gave a smile. It would only be a while. Do you belong to me? I saw you at that local deli, buying things for your family. I peeked, cupped hands into the window. Don't think that you noticed me. You went walking in the sunshine. It bounced and glimmered off your hair. I reached a hand, wanted to say your name, but I ran and jumped into my van. I know this was meant to be. Won't be hard to make you see. A future written in the stars. You can heal my deepest scars, 'cause you belong to me. I crept around your kitchen window. I saw your husband standing there. He looked at me so very shocking, and I grinned and slowly slicked my hair. He came out with that badge and pistol, and I felt my violent inner rage. It got the best of me, so I ran at him. Aimed and shot, now here I lay. And as I lay and slowly die, I have no questions why. You're crying, staring straight at me. I think I finally made you see that you belong to me.
Nice.
Very nice.
See, it's a nice peaceful song, right? It's family oriented. Yeah.
It's definitely family oriented.
It's a love song.
It's a love song.
It is a love song.
It is.
A dark love song, but it is a love song. Nonetheless. Which is,
yeah. So it still qualifies.
Right.
Give or take.
My thoughts.
I mean, it depends on whose mind we're in. If it's, I mean, some people that might be love, you know?
Well.
Yeah, if you're crazy. If you're crazy like that Abaddon Phallus character, yeah, it might be true. You know?
That's funny.
Oh.
And that's, you know, and that's the thing, man. You know,
and next on Law and Order SVU.
Dun. With that voice. Next time on Law and Order. Abaddon Phallus.
Ice T's gonna have to smack him.
Yeah, he's going to have to. What's this Abaddon Phallus guy? Like, what was he doing?
He was singing songs about murder.
That's the voice. You know what, man? I'll tell
you. In an alley.
in an alleyway, like the Batman
it's
thing.
More believable.
I would think so. You know, here's the thing too. To tell you, like, there's a nature to it. Like, I'll give you an example. Mm-hmm. So, being in Salem, Massachusetts, like, hello, right?
Yeah.
We did stuff like we went to all the little shops and looked at all the witch stuff in the Satanic Temple, you know, which is in there, you know, all this stuff. Let me tell you what, man. Like, if you're a macabre guy like me, you like horror stuff, or just even history in general. Like, that is the town. You're gonna live in Danvers or nearby. You know, you're gonna do that. That town is. I was there for 2 days, and it was the most relaxing, very cool. You know what I mean? Like everything mm-hmm. I was looking at, like nothing was surprising to me. I'm like, no, this is cool. No, this. If I had a town, this is what I'd put in the town. Yeah. And everybody was super friendly and cool, and it was super nice. And I was like, why? We need to have a bunch of towns like Salem. That are just like really dark, macabre, weird stuff that they're not scared to do it and just do it, you know? Like,
true.
Any place I've been to around, if they do weird stuff like that or they have a history of weird stuff, they try to run from it as much as possible. And this place does not run. They're just like, no, bro, here's what's happening.
We are going to reenact burning witches every year.
Yeah, dude. For a whole month of October, they're like, you're going to die the whole month. All day long. And, dude, it's great, man. And, like, everybody was so friendly and everybody was so nice. And this is the thing. This is what I'm getting at with this whole little yakety-yakety speech. So people that know me, we're talking about this on the way up here. Okay. Right, I get this enigma like complex thing. People say like, we don't really know if Mike Edgerly is the kind of guy that really does horrible things to people with a fork, or if he's just singing about it. And I'm like, come on, man. Like, I got kids, married. Like, come on. It's a gimmick.
More demented things on TV.
Yes,
or movies.
Absolutely. Like, I love horror stuff, and I think it's really funny to sing about it. And I mean, I run with it because that's what helps sell the albums. Like, oh, yes, maybe I do. Maybe. You know, but at the same time, I'm kind of like, how goofy are people that they take me seriously in any way, shape, or form? Like, if I'm wearing a satanic shirt and you take me seriously, you got an issue. Like, maybe you are the problem. You know what I mean? Because I'm having fun, man. Like, this kind of music is hilarious and it's fun. And people take it way too seriously. You know what I mean?
No, I get it. Yeah, there's more messed up things now in like movies.
Oh,
yeah.
Easily.
Than anything.
And they're more serious than what I'm doing. Like, I'm singing about silly stuff for the most part. I don't think we have any lyrics. We don't swear in any songs. We don't have anything that's like really objectifying or, you know what I mean? I'm not trying to popularize like, I'm not trying to do the American Psycho thing. I'm not trying to popularize like murder or anything. Either was Elliot when he wrote it, but you know what I'm saying? You get what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm not trying to like do all that. And I think sometimes that gets confused. I'll play shows and we get the face, you know, which I think is hilarious to me that people take it. And you're one of the very few radio stations that really like embraces any music that will come in completely. Like I played this place and a few other ones, and some places get my music and go, I don't know, man. You know, it's like our audience might kind of flip out because you're talking about that. Like, I'm that's so.
I can think of one off the top of my head.
Mm. I know for a fact Gannon will never have me on the radio station. They're completely a Christian college, like 100%, not half and half. Like, I know college has some too, but
I guess if that's what you like, that's what your business plan is. Yes. I guess that's understandable.
Yes, but Lakeland is, and they're like, no, okay, man, come on in, dude. Like, sing it. Like, you know, because they're just like, it is what it is. It's a show. You know, it's not like he's doing anything. He's not being racist or horrible or.
It's sort of that fine line of, like, when we sort of developed here of, it's sort of that thing of, sort of, even though we're not technically, we're working on the whole going FM thing, but not technically, but it's good practice to sort of get that a little. But it's not like they have a big darn list that you can find, you know, out there that we sort of just came off top of our head of, this is what we don't want to do.
Yeah.
Right. And that's the one thing, the credibility to college and that, then not playing us sort of academic in the college, that you sort of have, hey, you know, some credibility that you're not just random schmoes thinking that they're sitting in here with beer.
You know what? You know what? I'll tell you what, man. This is
that creasy line.
Yeah, it's like, dude.
It's not a big smoked out room.
No, you know what it is. It's like it's not going to be crack an egg off Letterkenny. You know, crack an egg, but you can't. It's not going to be like that. You know, but
true.
And, you know, and the other thing that's really funny too is like, so I've been on the major labels. I've done that twice.
Yeah,
and like. College stations and DIY record labels, that's the way to go. Like this, dude, I'll tell you what, no slam on this, but say you were like a major record, not a major record label, I'm saying a major radio station, and I'm not going to name any names because we all know those, right?
Yeah.
I don't even care if my music's played on there because you're usually music in the background of an office and no one really hears you, or you're played so much in turnaround that it's just, it becomes, people start hating your music. Because the same song is played every hour on the hour, which people would think that's a great thing. I don't think it is. It's like overplaying a bar. You don't want to do that.
It's almost like Shake It Up by Taylor Swift. How much that got burned out.
Yep. And here's a funny thing. You know what? On that. So I'll be the first to say this because we're doing this Facebook Live too. So I'll be the first to say, like, Taylor Swift isn't a bad songwriter. She writes her own songs. It's not like she's a horrible songwriter. She writes music, but she's played so much and there's so much behind it that it's you're just like, I don't even want to look at her face anymore because it's like Katy Perry was spun so much you just hate Katy Perry. You know, and I never want to get like that. College stations don't do that. You guys don't spin it so much it gets sick.
Oh.
And you'll take a chance on stuff that you probably other stations would never do. You know, this.
It's true.
Right. Like this. I would never get played on a major station. There's no way in hell they would play any of these songs.
It's probably those slim few, but you would have to go through a hell of a lot to find those few.
Big hoops, man.
I feel it. Yep. The other thing is, the one weird thing, they just spin you. They don't go and say, you know, hey, this is who it is, like us.
Yeah.
We voice in, like he sent me the tracks. We sat here. Voiced in Serva Beginning, local music spotlight here on Like Effect Radio. Insert each and every person's name of who it is and each and every single name of the song.
Yeah.
So even when we're not here at like midnight, when it runs through, someone's in, which we get people from Europe, all that, they're watching in and that you know
that
who it is.
They know who it is.
Oh, yeah, dude. And I get like last time I played here, I got about 17 or so. Emails because we did the Facebook page and the advertising, and I got emails or Facebook messages from all kinds of people that were just like, I think I saw you in Geneva once or something. You know what I mean? Like, oh, you that looping guy? I'm like, yeah. And it was funny, and they didn't know I had my own albums out that were, because a lot of when I first started, I did a lot of cover stuff. I mean, that's how I got my name out there for a minute, because it takes a minute.
Yeah. Which that's what you get people comfortable with that, you know, because they sort of hear those songs-ish.
And, And now the majority of our show is completely Abbott on Phallus. Like, we'll throw a few covers here and there if we have to, but for the most part, we pretty much keep it, you know, we're at that point, which is good.
Yeah.
Did you want to play any of our tracks for the Iron Solstice Tour, or do you want us to play live? It's up to you.
Your choice.
I don't. Do you want to do one of them?
I always leave it necessarily to you guys.
Yeah,
to make
you know what?
Decisions.
You know what? Why don't you do? Why don't you play 27 Days, and then we'll play another live one? Because I kind of want to. I like to have people hear what we're talking about, so they kind of know the dealio.
Yeah.
If you have it in there.
The full drums.
I did. Huh.
Chiming in the
stupid
background.
Stupid card computer.
Yeah, they're evil. Or if they just recently
updated this to 10 last Friday.
Oh, man.
So I'm still working kinks out of it.
Yeah. I mean, if you have you know, any one of them, that's fine. It doesn't matter which one. Yeah.
Let's see.
If you have a way, I thought you had a way, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, go ahead and play that one. It's all the same. I just want them to hear what the new sound sounds like.
Let's see.
Give or take, you know?
San Francisco's in here. Why is it? Okay, name me, you want Rocket Man?
No, that one's Anthems of Apathy. You don't want to do that.
Okay.
That's my metal band. Although that'd be cool to play. And that's a raging cover. But
Open First?
Oh, yeah, Open Fist. Those are all old songs. Those are all old songs.
Yeah.
So, you know what? Here, we'll just
for
do 27 days.
Reason.
We'll just play 27 days. If you want to go in your email and pull out Away from San Francisco while we play this song, and then they can kind of hear the real song. All right, so 27 days. Let me give a little background story on this, right? We'll do that. Because this is crazy. Crazy. So this song was first called Putrefication. And I thought that was kind of gross. So I said, maybe we shouldn't call it that. And so I changed it to 27 Days because it is about a man who has a woman, falls in love with her, they get married. She plays with a Ouija board, gets possessed by a demon, and dies in the house, right? So she's been dead for 27 days up to this point of the song. And he can't take her anywhere or do anything with her because she's demon-possessed, right? So this is his story of how that is.
Stairs, like she might have something to hide. Hey, you're gonna eat that. Smiled and pushed my eggs aside, so don't keep the lights on. Looked at me with those pretty eyes. She didn't like my gourmet coffee. What the hell's with all the flies in? My girl's been dead for 27 days. Been playing with that Ouija board. The demon says it's not a game board. It's all I've got, shame. Looking through that plant she'd tell. What's the name, demon? Tell me your name, boy. Can't take her shopping. Everybody wins and stares. Especially with her sour smell. All the worms driving in her hair. So I bring her home some magazines. Spins her head and lasts for hours. Burning sage and I'm hanging flowers. Cause my girl's been dead for 27 days. Playing with that Ouija board. Demon says it's not a game board. It's all a goddamn shame. Looking through that plant you tell. What's your name, demon? Tell me your name, boy. My girl's been dead for 27 days. Playing with that Ouija board. Demon says it's not a game board. It's all a goddamn shame. Looking through that plant you tell. What's your name, demon? Tell me your name, boy. My girl's been dead for 27 days. Playing with that Ouija board. Demon says it's not a game board. It's all a goddamn shame, yeah. Looking through that plant, you tell him, what's your name, demon? Tell me your name, boy.
Ooh, yeah. It's a nice family song.
It is. It definitely is. But I got to be this person.
Go ahead,
I'll have your new stuff.
Yeah, right.
You sort of know where I'm probably going to go.
I don't know. Maybe. Go ahead. Shoot it.
So, top three songs.
Off anything new I've written?
Yes.
Oh, that's tough, man. This is an EP. There's only five songs on it. So, I'll give you the top two that I think.
Okay.
That I like the best. There was this real... And here's the thing. You got to hear it, the whole song, for what it is. Not acoustically. But there's a song called You're Supposed to Be in the Ground, Becky. That is like an amazing, like, bossa nova kind of jam with like a little bit of reggae kind of mix. It's got a whole bunch of influences in it,
kinda,
right?
Yeah, like when I play the bass line, I kind of feel like I'm jamming like the Police or something.
Yeah, so, yeah. And then it's got a bunch of shuffly. You got to hear the track on the album. That's one definitely people are going to look for. I think we're going to do a music video for that one more than anything. And then honestly, I would say probably 27 Days. Like that song right there was really, really fun to do. Away from San Francisco is pretty fun. But those two, I think, are my top two favorite ones. When we play shows, I'm like, oh my God, I love doing these two songs because they're so ridiculous.
You know? I feel it.
Yeah.
You go with?
I mean, as far as the new album, yeah, I would agree. Those are probably my...
What's your big old one, favorite? Man?
My favorite old one to play is Illusion Land.
Dude, Illusion Land is killer.
Dude, I love that song. I've listened to the original recording of it, but like the way we do it live,
way better.
I love it's like it's different than what it was, but it's still it's
we're gonna
it's,
do
it
a
sounds good.
We're gonna do a live bootleg album unannounced to any record label that I'm on, and they're not gonna say anything about it. We're gonna do this live bootleg album. It's gonna be like a bunch of new stuff. I'm writing four songs right now, and then we're gonna do Illusion Land. And it's kind of like the old stuff, how it's done now, because it's so different. And people that have that album, maybe we'll do that one before we leave. We'll do Illusion Land, because that'd be really cool to do. Yeah, we'll have to do that in Oldie. We'll have to do Illusion Land. We'll play that song. That's off the album. That's like 10 years ago that album came out. And then he put some life into that thing. Yeah, when Haley started playing bass, I'm like, oh, that's a different take on that song. I like it more. You know, let me make sure I'm tuned, because I'm horrible.
That's kind of funny. I didn't know about that. Bootleg.
Yeah, we're going to do it. It's not done yet. We're going to do it. It's going to happen. I don't care.
Making your own bootleg album?
Yep.
Hey, but if you think, that's kind of smart. It's that people necessarily bootlegging you, that you're bootlegging yourself to make money or whatever.
You know, and that's the thing. I am not going to sit here and pretend. Let me tell you what. So, Reddy, I'm going to be that guy. And if anybody thinks that I'm not being true, it's like, let me just tell you. Half the posts I see, half the bootlegs I see, half the live material I see is canned, to the point where you go and you watch Eric Clapton live. They mix it in a studio, and they even have him come in and redo guitar parts on live stuff that I'm like, that's not even live. And then bootlegs, dude, I know bands right now I can name, and I won't, that do live bootlegs of themselves and say they're bootlegs. They'll pass them around and go, we didn't know anything. You recorded it. Like, you were there. I was at the show. You had the sound guy record the show, and then you put it out as a bootleg and pretended you didn't have anything to do with it. Like, it's like, so I'm going to say right now to the audience, hey, I'm putting out my own bootleg because I don't care, and you're going to dig it. It's going to be fun, and we're going to have a good time with it. And that's what we're doing.
Exactly. Yeah. So it's kind of smart in the first sense of
marketing.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say.
Marketing. For anybody watching Facebook Live, look at my face right now, my stupid-looking face. Marketing. Get it down. Look at Red over here. Look at Giant Red. He'll tell you marketing. So, you know what? Here, we'll do Illusion Land. We'll do Illusion Land right now. How about that? Is that cool?
Yeah.
All right, so this is different. This song was on the first album. Done entirely different.
She beckons me, a lonely way to her sea, rolling deep. Illusion land, it's fantasy. The truth is there, and I still believe the time has slipped away. And gone is riddles lost on a hopeless race, and I shall never look upon her majestic face. And so she is gone. No, she's gone. Souls in the deep, they're calling me. Another ghost for the locker, and time has slipped away. And gone is riddles lost on a hopeless race. And I shall never look upon her majestic face. And so she is gone.
Insert guitar solo.
And on the wind, she beckons me. A lonely way to her sea, it's rolling deep. Illusion land, it's fantasy. The truth is there, and I time has slipped away, and gone is riddles lost on a hopeless race, and I shall never look upon her majestic face. So she is gone, now she's gone.
Yeah, that definitely was a different twist.
Oh, big time. If you listen to the real one, it's nothing like that. I mean, yeah. I don't even sing it that way. And the whole bridge is taken out. We took the whole bridge out that I don't even do at all. It's like, yeah, totally involved into this really commercial pop. It's very like Neil Young pop music. If you think about it, it sounds very Neil Youngish without like the, you know, Canadian influence of vocal technique he uses, which no one else in Canada does, so I'm sorry, Canada, I didn't mean to do that to you. I'm not saying Neil Young's a bad singer, I'm just saying he's horrible. I love you, Neil.
He's got some good music, though.
He's got amazing music. There's an album he put out called Prairie Wind that I religiously live by. That's such a beautiful album. The music, the songs on it are amazing. The live version, if I'm going to plug him for a second, the live version DVD, if you ever get a chance to get Prairie Wind live DVD, it was formed in Nashville, and it is the coolest concert you'll ever see. The drums, just I'll give you a sort like this, so cool, man. He's playing the songs. The drummer decides, I'm not going to play drums. I'm going to stand on stage with a broom and I'm going to sweep on a little sweeping pad into a microphone, and that's a ch ch ch. You hear it's a broom, and I'm like, how cool is that? He went that folky and like that artsy. That. Yeah, and he does it live on a broom, and I'm like, that is freaking cool. At first, you're like, what is this fool doing? And then you hear it, and you go, what, dude, this is cool. Like, that is really cool.
Yeah.
I would steal that idea if he'd already didn't do it.
Was this before or after Stomp the musical?
This was long after. This is right after he had a stroke, actually. Remember when Neil Young had that stroke? He had that stroke. That was right after he had the stroke.
Yeah.
Or very, very, or maybe right before it. But yeah, and it was really cool.
Within that, one or the other.
It was, yeah, it was really cool, man. That was a great album. Yeah. So, Neil, sorry, dude. I just don't like your voice, but that's okay. You still write great music. I mean, I feel that way about a lot of people, Bob Dylan.
We all have our personal taste of who we sort of care for.
But still love. But still love. My voice
or
ain't
certain
great.
Certain little tweaks.
Yeah. My voice ain't awesome, but you know, hey. I make money doing music.
But yeah, I definitely see that why you would love that.
It's awesome, yeah. And that song is very, and that Illusion Land is very, it is. When I wrote it, I'm not gonna lie, I was thinking of Neil Young when I did it. I was. So, and I kind of sang it that way on the album. If you listen, it's got a very Neil Young kind of vocal on the original album. Not now, but it did then, 10 years ago. I think even more than that. I think that album was, it was officially released almost 11 years ago. And then, probably 9 years, actually more realistically like 9 years. And then it was re-released again. When I got signed to the label, they did the re-release of it, and we put it back out. And then I did You and Me and a Devil Make Three. And we'll do a song off that album, too, because no one's heard that album. Here, I'm saying, on your radio stations. No one's here has heard that album, as far as I know.
I've never heard that album.
Yeah, he plays on it. He doesn't play bass on it, but he plays. Now, this is the first album, by the way, where I'm not playing all the instruments. He's playing bass on this album, on the new album. Dark Folk. I'm not playing everything. And you can totally tell that I'm not playing everything because the bass is good. Yeah. Because I'm that. I'm not a great bass player. I'm a guitar player playing bass. And that's not a bass player.
No,
so,
I get it. It's sort of that mixture.
Right. And I can admit that. And some people can't. They're like, I'm a great bass player. I'm like, sir, stop it. You're a guitar player playing bass.
That's like me when I knew how to, or was sort of playing bass. Guitar.
You're like, I don't know. Yeah, no, I get it.
Well, the only reason I got suckered into doing bass was one thing. Sophomore year, you know, that ending person jazz band's leaving. They asked like two people before that.
Dude, we've all been there.
you know, hey, you know, we need a bass, whatever, player for jazz band.
Do you ever recognize, I mean, dude, do you ever realize right now it's always that? It's never like, hey, we got this gig, right? And we can't really find anybody. So, like, do you play drums? Like, can you just play drums? No one ever does that. They need a drum player. They don't go, can you play guitar or piano? It's always like, hey, we'll take any mediocre guy that can play a bass. Do you know how to play bass or even think you can? Like, why do the people think that bass is such a low characteristic instrument that it doesn't take talent to play it? It does. And, and if you and you can totally tell someone who plays bass and someone who doesn't, even if they play bass. Wink, wink. Like, yeah, I've seen it.
She had like four or five people she was playing on, and I was sort of the third one in the list of, you know, well, you know bass stuff, and I, you, yeah, you don't know anything about guitar, but will you be willing to learn in between, you know, over the summer?
Do you know what I think ruined it? Let me tell you what. Here's what I think ruined bass. I think Fleetwood Mac ruined bass, because anybody can go.
They ruined a lot of things.
They did. And you know what? And when he just went up there and was like, hey, my name is McVie, check this out. Whole song. That's it. Just follow me. That was the whole thing. I'm like, bro, that's your song for 17 minutes? And then the next song. Hey, I got another one. I'm like, just... he ruined it for everyone. So, thank you.
I'm pretty sure we just made a lot of people mad.
I don't care.
By talking about Fleetwood Mac.
Whatever. Stevie Nicks sings like a goat.
Well, that's
I'm
only
done.
One artist.
I mean, yeah. While we're making people mad, I don't like the Grateful Dead either.
Neither do I. I like the Grateful Dead. I'm glad that whole thing's over. Seriously.
Yeah.
Or Fish, okay? Knock it off with a PH. I get it. I mean, cool. It's trendy. Knock it off. They play good. Dude, he can play guitar amazingly.
I like what Trey Anastasio did with Oyster Head.
Yeah.
That was cool.
But then again, I'm the fool that likes Primus a lot, too. So there's that. Like, right? It's like, there's no way you can go, I like Geddy Lee and I like... you know, Les Claypool, and I like Grateful Dead or Fisher. No, you can't, because you can't be that insane and then go, but I'll go that calm too. Like, it doesn't exist. Like, I love Pink Floyd, right? But yeah. Roger Waters is a horrible bass player. I love Roger Waters to death, but he just kind of goes and sings. He doesn't do anything. It's very, I think the most riffy thing he does is Run Like Hell. He's like, then he goes, and he's like, slides. That's all he does. Then he's like, that's like the most he does. That's the whole song. If it wasn't for his cool lyrics, that would be horrible. So
yeah.
Now we're just turning into jerks. We're not supposed to be out here promoting music. And we're being jerks about music.
We're at Mount Palace. We play Dark Folk.
Yeah, we're having on Fells. We're mean about other bands. It's not really nice.
Mean about other famous
bands. Can I give
bands.
A cool shout out to some people that you guys have had on here? Look at, man, Sean Benjamin, amazing. If you haven't caught him locally, he is the deal. Mike McFarlane, good buddy of mine. Kim Kennedy, holy crap. If you don't know Kim Kennedy, you're foolish. She's amazing vocalist and a great body painter. And then you got like Kevin Conway, holy crap. That guy's voice is gold. Do you know why I miss, man? Nick Wilkinson has moved to Chicago, and that guy could sing so good. He moved away.
I've been trying to always get him up.
Dude, Nick is amazing, and I talk to him all the time on Facebook, or I shout him out on Instagram or whatever. That dude can jam. And locally, man, those are the cats. Like, they've been on the show. You've had them on here. And there's some other bands that I'm looking on your wall now that I'm looking at, that I'm like, wow, man, you've had some dudes. I know a
funny
lot of
thing,
these dudes.
Kevin's going to be next month or November.
Yeah, he's so talented.
Either
dude.
The first or second.
He's super talented,
November.
Man. Matter of fact, you're already plug again. Yeah, so we're playing the Ugly Tuna in Erie, Pennsylvania this weekend, Friday.
Whoa.
Saturday, Edinburgh Hotel in Edinburgh, PA. Both times, one's the first one's 6 o'clock, Edinburgh Hotel's 8 o'clock.
Yeah, 8 to 11.
8 to 11.
I love that place.
So don't I. It's so sexy there. They make good sandwiches.
There's some places that you play and you're like, I would almost play here for free.
Yeah. Look at that picture of Mike McFarlane on the wall.
But my cell phone bills do.
Mike McFarlane, wherever you are right now, I'm looking at your picture of you on a bike with shades on and gloves, and I'm just like, look at this cat.
That was last time.
Yeah. I love Mike, man.
It's
so funny.
It's sort of a priceless picture.
He's good, man. I love him. He's a character, man. He's a character.
The in-between of trying to look cool, but sort of looking like a badass, but be real.
But at the same time, I'm going to play pop music. I love him. I love Mike. Mike, if you're out there listening, I love you. So we got a song off, and do we have time to do one more?
Yeah.
Because I know we got, like, what, like, until one? Yeah. Okay, cool. We'll do a song off You Mean a Devil Make Three, and then we can, like, that'd be cool.
Yeah.
Awesome. All right, man, we'll do that. This song is called Was That My Axe?
Okay.
This is a really fun blues tune that we made about a guy killing his wife after he comes home from work and she just bugs him about coffee. He's had it. The grounds. I've been sitting here wasting time. I did what it did because it gave me peace of mind. You say I'm the devil, yeah, it was a crime. But being around you was punishment, baby, I think I served my time. I said, ho, ain't that the damn truth, because baby, you know I will. Retell this story all the way to hell. They tell me didn't have time to run. I did what I did and I killed you for the fun. But the ones who know you say that's all a lie. See, they knew how you was on your insides. And I said, oh, but ain't that the damn truth? Cause baby, you know I will. We tell my story all the way to hell. Not on the album here is where we have a nice organ solo. But it's not here. Let's pretend. All right, that's close. The judge, the jury, and the plaintiff's plea said I'm insane and should not be allowed to be. Let them live and see the years. My children's children and my fellow peers. They grow old, but ain't that the damn truth? Cause baby, you know I will. We tell my story all the way to hell.
Nice.
It was fun.
So.
It's rounding up, man. Rounding up the hour.
I know.
Who else is coming in? Who else is coming in after us? Anybody?
Musicians? No.
Oh,
it's another Cleveland Geary Lee tomorrow.
Nice.
Because he sort of does Beatles, all that stuff.
Oh, that's cool.
And that his own little sort of mix there. Not including next month, we got 20 something.
Nice, dude.
And that.
Well, people need to listen to the station. So if you don't, we'll come to SmackDown. So we'll be advertising
Facebook
this
Live.
Facebook Live, you see it. If you don't listen to Lake Effects Radio, you can go to lakeeffectsradio.org. Where else can they find it? What's the channel?
Facebook.
What's
we're working on that.
Okay, so it's Facebook. What's the tag so I get it right?
Was it Lake Effect Radio Station?
Oh, it's just Lake Effect Radio Station. Okay, well, that's simple, man. It's Lake Effect Radio Station Facebook.
Except Twitter's different. That's at just the minus the station.
Yeah,
off
so
of
it's
it.
Just at Lake Effect Radio. Yeah.
The bird.
Yeah, Shorty, you know.
Yep.
And that, but yeah.
Dude, thanks for having us, man.
Oh, no problem, man.
It's been a year since I've been here, and this was cool.
I know. Not including definitely like the new style.
Yeah, it's different.
Yeah, it's definitely different.
I'll send you an album as soon as it gets. I mean, it's in production right now. There's people that already prepaid. We're sorry. I'm sorry it hasn't come out yet. We've been dragging our feet. I'm going to tell you right now, it is I'm going to do this public service announcement. Here it is.
Things happen.
Some of the problem has been me procrastinating mixing. The rest of the problem has been certain people in the industry dragging their feet that are supposed to be doing it that are not. We'll leave that alone. But it'll be here. And when it gets here, I will send out those albums to those people that have paid for them. Thank you so much for supporting Abaddon Files. I'll send you one so you can check it out, man. You can spin it and have fun with it. And then, you know, tell me what you think about it, man. I'd like to hear what people think. I like to hear people's opinions.
Usually thinking stuff happens.
Haley has to buy one. I'm not giving him one. I don't care.
Man. I gotta buy the album that I'm on.
I charge my kids. I'm like, my kid's like, Dad, can I have a T-shirt? I'm like, $20. I'm just kidding. I don't do that.
I'll throw in a sticker.
I charge him 50. I charge him. Yeah. I don't charge my kids $20. I charge my kids $15. I give them a break. I mean, work for what you want. You know what I'm saying? That's right. Has some cool.
I'm telling you, if you throw in a sticker or a magnet, that kind of sweetens the pot, man.
It does. I got cool magnets. By the way, we got cool merch. Please stop by a show. Go on AbaddonPhallus.com. Stop by a show. We got all kinds of cool T-shirts, magnets, shirts, mugs. Really cool, man. We got all kinds of cool stuff. We even have a little mascot. His name is Sammy Sater. It's a little Sater that sits on our table, and he hangs out, and you can tip him. He loves it. We got stickers and CDs and, man, name it. We even take the square because we're hip to be square.
Hip.
To be square.
But
that's his job to know that stuff. I don't even know what he's talking about. A square.
A square is like a chip reader.
Like cigarettes?
Yeah. That's what I was thinking. Isn't it the
What'd
square?
What'd you say?
A cigarette? You got a square,
a square?
Man?
I don't smoke cigarettes. I'm straight edge, people.
Selling merch and that and add square, that's what I was thinking. You
right.
Know?
Yeah, the square. Yeah. Yeah, you're doing the square like you're charging people on the square. Yeah, man. Yeah, we take credit cards. The square. Cool, man.
And we promise we will not send your credit card information to Nigeria, and you will not get an email about you may have possibly inherited $1.2 billion. Just send us some information about yourself.
And if you get that email, just answer it. Don't be. Just live dangerously. Live deliciously, as it said in the movie with the witch.
I always want to be funny and create a bank account, just a fake account with nothing in it, just to send it to those people. They go and try to take anything. It's nothing in it.
That would be amazing.
I always want to do that.
Guys, anybody out there on Facebook land that's listening to us right now, if you want to do what he just said, you contact Abaddon Phallus, Mike Abaddon Phallus on Facebook. We will set up a fake bank account together as Abaddon Phallus and you, and we will start doing that.
We will send it to the Nigerian prince.
We will. 50 cents, whatever it takes. We need to get this guy new clothes. He is in pain. Awesome. Thanks, man.
No problem, man. It's always a pleasure. Absolutely. Pleasure meeting you.
Thank you. Thanks for having us on.